I do not believe there is a double standard of morality. The societies in which many of us live have for more than a generation failed to foster moral discipline. They've taught that truth is relative and that everyone decides for himself or herself what is right. Concepts such as sin and wrong have been condemned as value judgments. As the Lord describes it, every man walketh in his own way and after the image of his own God. As a consequence, self-discipline has eroded, and societies are left to try to maintain order and civility by compulsion. The lack of internal control by individuals breeds external control by governments. One columnist observed that gentlemanly behavior, for example, once protected women from coarse behavior. Today, we expect sexual harassment laws to restrain coarse behavior. Policemen and laws can never replace customs, traditions, and moral values as a means for regulating human behavior. At best, the police and criminal justice system are the last desperate line of defense for a civilized society. Our increased reliance on laws to regulate behavior is a measure of how uncivilized we've become. There could never be enough rules so finely crafted as to anticipate and cover every situation. And even if there were, enforcement would be impossibly expensive and burdensome. This approach leads to diminished freedom for everyone. In the memorable phrase of Bishop Fulton J. Sheen, "We would not accept the yoke of Christ, so now we must tremble at the yoke of Caesar." In the end, it is only an internal moral compass in each individual that can effectively deal with the root causes as well as symptoms of societal decay. Societies will struggle in vain to establish the common good until sin is denounced as sin and moral discipline takes its place in the pantheon of civic virtues. All of us experience temptations, so did the Savior, but he gave no heed unto them. Similarly, we do not have to yield simply because a temptation surfaces. We may want to, but we don't have to. An incredulous female friend asked a young adult woman committed to living the law of chastity how it was possible that she'd never slept with anybody. "Don't you want to?" the friend asked. The young woman thought, "The question intrigued me because it was so utterly beside the point. Mere wanting is hardly a proper guide for moral conduct." We cannot presume that the future will resemble the past. The things and patterns we've relied upon economically, politically, socially, will remain as they have been. Perhaps our moral discipline, if we will cultivate it, will have an influence for good and inspire others to pursue the same course. We may thereby have an impact on future trends and events. At a minimum, moral discipline will be of immense help to us as we deal with whatever stresses and challenges may come in a disintegrating society. I stand with my brethren and with you, my brothers and sisters, as a witness that God is our Father and that His Son Jesus is our Redeemer. Their law is immutable, their truth is everlasting, and their love is infinite. In the name of Jesus Christ, amen.